the work the men do. Paul Rubin, that nigga a seminal, that nigga a shooter, but this shit was spiritual. Plus I called Judah if I wanna put an end to you. Yeah, you know I'm me from crazy Puerto Rican with a long nose under my seat, man. It's death before the sun or the sea, man. Cause there ain't no fucking honor in defeat, man. We ain't screaming no justice, no peace. Commanding General Yohana, he doesn't raise weak men. Men, we strong for the fight, armed to the teeth. Warriors in Christ, I feel like King David with the sword and the shield. Like, nigga, we could go to war on this hill fight. Nigga, we could go to war on this build, right? Right, and I'll show you what that real's like. Them boys straight left, I chose life. Them boys chose death. I stand as a man till I have no breath. My spirit leaving my body, loved ones back in my chest. See these scriptures, you gon' get it word of mouth. Battle UPK, welcome to the slaughterhouse. And all them same niggas that think of us be them same niggas we never thought about.
Shalom, Israel. We're the Israelite School of Universal and Practical Knowledge, started out of One West, Harlem, New York, 125th Street, under Commanding General Yohana. Today, we want to get into a topic that every Christian pastor think they understand. Everybody that think they know the Bible, they think they understand it. But the thing that they don't do is go into the history out the Bible.
That's right.
They don't understand that all the answers you, all the questions you got can be answered through the scriptures. But they don't read the Bible enough to really see that. So we're going to break down some stuff for them. We're going to go into some history in the Bible. You know, we're going to actually read the Bible.
Right.
And we're going to show who the Gentiles are that can be saved. You know, that new doctrine popped up that Christ died for everybody on the earth. That's not in the Bible at all. So we're going to clear all this misconception up. We're going to see how the kingdom split and how it's supposed to be rejoined back together. And we're going to bring some understanding to this topic. So the first thing we got to understand is that the Most High never intended for us to join with these other nations, to intermingle. You know what I mean? Give me Deuteronomy 7 and start 3. He never intended for us to intermingle with these other nations. That aggravates the Lord when we do things like that. Read that out.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 3. Neither shalt thou make marriages with them.
Mm-hmm.
Thy daughters thou shalt not give unto his sons.
See, we're not supposed to give our daughters to their sons. We're not supposed to marry. And that's why the Lord flooded the earth with Noah. Because the daughters of the sons of God, the sons... What is called? How is it word?
The sons of God.
The sons of God looked upon the daughters of men. We the sons of the Most High, Yahshua, the princes of the power.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? And the sons of Adam. Adam was the son of God because he was the first one brought into the truth. So the Lord destroyed the earth because of us going into these other nations. And that repeats every time. You know what I'm saying? Keep reading.
Nor his daughter shalt thou take unto thy son.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 4. For they will turn away thy son from following me.
They going to do what?
They shall turn away thy son from following me.
That's what they did. They turned away us from following the Most High. Now let me go to 1 Kings 11. We're going to start at like verse 3.
Come on to one come. It's the book of 1 Kings, chapter 11. Verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
And he had 700 wives.
Wait a minute. He only had one wife.
And he had 700 wives.
Who are we talking about here? We're talking about King Solomon. King Solomon had 700 wives. Keep reading.
Count out of one count. Princesses.
Wait a minute. Queens.
Princesses.
No, there's queens in Israel.
Princesses.
The princesses. You know what I'm saying? We don't have any queens in Israel.
That's right.
Well, we did have a queen. Who was it? Jezebel,
kind of the one
a bitch. That's the kind of, that's why we don't have those type of, we don't have queens in Israel. Keep reading.
Kind of the one kind. And 300 concubines.
Mm, keep reading.
And his wives turned away his heart.
You know why his wives turned away his heart? Because he married other nations.
That's right.
There wasn't, there's not 1,000 sisters from Israel. These, some of these women were heathens. And that's what we just read in Deuteronomy, that they're going to turn your heart away from the Most High. Keep reading.
Count on the one kind. Verse 4. For it came to pass, when Solomon was old, that his wives turned away his heart after other gods.
His wives did what?
Turned away his heart after other gods.
Keep reading.
And his heart was not perfect with the Lord his God.
Keep reading.
As was the heart of David, his father.
See, people don't understand what perfection is. Now, we know that David sinned. We know that he took the Hittite's wife. We know that he, you know what I'm saying? But the scripture said that he was perfect.
Right.
Because being perfect is not a thing that you look at like you start from birth and you end perfect when you die.
Right.
That's not what that is. It's following the laws. It's having a zeal to do what it is that the Most High wants you to do. You understand? And the scripture said that after this, at this time when he started following after these other gods, his heart, his mind wasn't perfect. He wasn't set toward doing the will of the Most High. He did what he wanted to do. Keep reading.
Count on the one kind. Verse 5. For Solomon went after...
Wait, drop down to verse 9.
Count on the one kind.
We got a lot to read today, so we want to just get to the point.
Count on the one kind. This is 1 Kings chapter 11, verse 9. Mm-hmm. And the Lord was angry with Solomon because his heart was turned from the Lord God of Israel, which had appeared unto him twice.
The Lord appeared to him twice. You understand? He's a special man. And you going to turn away from the Most High after you done seen what you done seen?
Right.
Heard what you done heard? Experienced what you experienced? Yeah. So read verse 11.
Count out of one kind. Verse 11. Wherefore the Lord said unto Solomon, for as much as done of thee, thou hast not kept my covenant and my statutes, which I have commanded thee.
Right.
I will surely rend the kingdom from thee, and I will give it unto thy servant.
He going to give it to who?
And give it unto thy servant.
Hold where you at.
Come on, one,
give me Ecclesiastes 10 and 7. Let's get some understanding. Now, the Lord said, since you have done this wicked thing, I'm going to take the kingdom from you, and I'm going to give it to your servants. We are now living under our servants. Read that.
Count on one kind. It's the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 10, verse 7. I have seen servants upon horses.
Salakia, start at verse 6.
Count on one kind. Ecclesiastes, chapter 10, verse 6. Folly is set in great dignity, and rich is set in low places.
It say the foolish are sitting in great dignity. Folly, that's the foolish. It's sitting in great dignity, and the who?
And the rich sit in the low place.
And the rich sit in low places. That's why in Revelation it said, thou art rich. I know thy tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. We are the rich, but we sit in low places. Keep reading.
Verse 7. I have seen servants upon horses.
I've seen who?
Servants upon horses.
I've seen the white man riding on horses. I've seen the people that's supposed to be under the rich, they riding on horses.
Right.
Keep reading.
And princes walking as servants upon the earth.
And I see the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans walking. These princes, I see these guys walking on the earth like some slaves. This is foolishness in my... This is Solomon having a dream. And he's like, man, this is foolishness. I can't believe what I'm seeing.
Right.
You understand? That's it on that.
Come.
Now go back to where you at. So these servants that's ruling over us, this is the white man. Keep reading.
Count on one kind. It's the book of 1 Kings, chapter 11, verse 11. Wherefore the Lord...
No, started, you finished 11. Go to 12.
Count on one kind. Verse 12. Now, withstanding in thy days, I will not do it for David thy father's sake.
See, David was after the Lord's own heart. The Lord loved David. So, because of his father... He didn't do it. He didn't take the kingdom from Solomon for the wickedness that he'd done. See, what you don't understand is you got to pay for the sins of your forefathers.
Right.
That's why I said, prepare slaughter that they do not rise, nor possess. No, I said, prepare slaughter for his iniquity, for the sins of their fathers. They got to pay for the sins of their forefathers. I'm paraphrasing. But that's why he said, I'm not going to do this because of your father's sake. Because he was a righteous man. Read.
Kind of one kind. But I will rend it out the hands of thy son.
But I will take it from your son. Keep reading.
Kind of one kind. Verse 13. Howbeit, I will not rend away all the kingdom.
I'm not going to take all the kingdom from you. Read.
But will give one tribe to thy son for David my servant's sake, and for Jerusalem's sake, which I have chosen.
So the Lord, it's a prophecy being foretold now. He's saying, for because of what you have done, I'm going to take the kingdom from you, but not all of the kingdom. You understand? Keep reading.
Gone out of one kind. Chapter 14, verse 14. And the Lord stirred up an adversary unto Solomon.
Wait a minute. The Lord stirred up a what?
An adversary unto Solomon. Hadad and the Edomite.
Read that again. Hadad the who?
Hadad the Edomite.
He stirred up an adversary. What's an adversary? An enemy. He stirred up the Edomites. Read.
He was of the king's seed in Edom.
So now he's going to punish us with Edom. You understand? Now we're seeing how it's being split, and we're seeing who he's raising up in our stead. The Edomites were being risen up. Keep reading.
Count on the one come. Verse 15. For it came to pass when David was in Edom, and Joab, the captain of hosts, was gone up to bury at the slain after he did smite every male in Edom.
See? So Edom got a chip on their shoulder. Because we done already ran through there in the past and slayed all of the men. Now, some of them men and women ran off into some caves and hid. You understand? But majority of the men were killed. So now the Lord has stirred up this adversary against us because of our disobedience. You understand? Now we're finna get into how he get. What verse we at right now?
We just finished 15. We at 16 now, sir.
Okay. Go ahead, read 16.
Count on the one count. Verse 16. For 6 months did Joab remain there with all Israel until he had cut off every male in Edom.
Right. Now we're going to drop down to 23.
Count on the one count. This is the book of 1 Kings, chapter 11, verse 23. And God stirred him up another adversary.
Who?
Rezin, the son of Eladai, which fled from the Lord, had a Zer. King of Zoabah.
Now drop down to 26. Here we go.
Count out of one kind. Verse 26. And Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, the Ephraimite of Zeradah, Solomon's servant, whose mother was Zeruah, widow woman, even he lifted up his hand against the king.
So now you got Jeroboam. Jeroboam is about to be risen up. Let's see what's about to happen. Read that. Next, read all the way to 28.
Count on the one count. Verse 27. And this was the cause that he lifted his hand against the king. Solomon built Milo and repaired the breaches of the city of David his father. Verse 28. And the man Jeroboam was a mighty man of valor. And Solomon, seeing the young man that he was industrious, he made him ruler over all charge of the house of Joseph.
He made him ruler over all the house of Joseph. So now you got Solomon's son, Rehoboam, and then you have this servant's son, Jeroboam. Jeroboam was over the northern kingdom. He took the northern kingdom. Rehoboam, which was Solomon's son, he took the southern kingdom. So that would be Judah, Benjamin. And scripture said Judah and his fellows. That'd be Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. Because the way you got to see Levi is Levi were like the laws.
Right.
And the laws have a precinct in your neighborhood and all different neighborhoods. Well, they didn't have an inheritance. They didn't have a land. So they were in the midst of Israel. You understand? But we had the Levites with us, Judah, Benjamin. You understand? So now we're finna go into Let me get a verse 30.
Come on, one come. Book of 1 Kings, chapter 11, verse 30.
Yeah.
And Ahijah caught the new garment that was on him and rent in 12 pieces.
So now he's telling them how it's going to work. He got this brand new garment on. He ripped the garment into 12 pieces. Read.
Verse 31. And he said to Jeroboam, take three 10 pieces. Take thee 10 pieces, mm-hmm. for thus said the Lord, the God of Israel.
Take thee 10 pieces. You know what these 10 pieces represent? 10 tribes. Keep reading.
God on one con. Behold, I will rend the kingdom out of the hand of Solomon,
mm-hmm.
and will give 10 tribes to thee.
He gonna give 10 tribes unto you. That's what happened. So, who was Jeroboam? He had 10 tribes. You feel me? That's the northern kingdom. This is the split. Keep reading.
God on one con. Verse 32. But he shall have one tribe for my servant David's sake,
mm-hmm.
and for Jerusalem's sake, the city which I have chosen out of all the tribes of Israel.
So Judah going to have a partner. You understand? That partner is Benjamin. You understand? Drop down to verse 35.
God on one con. Verse 35. But I will take the kingdom out of his son's hand,
mm-hmm.
and will give it unto thee, even 10 tribes.
Mm-hmm. Now we're seeing the split. We're seeing us going from all 12. Now we're splitting up. And that's about to be northern kingdom and southern kingdom. That's what people don't mean. People don't remember the southern kingdom. Because in the New Testament, all they hear about is the Pharisees and the Sadducees. The Jews. They forgot that it was a whole other part of the family.
Right.
That was kicked out. You understand? We're going to get into that though. Keep reading.
Kana Makan. Verse 36. And unto his son I will give one tribe,
mm-hmm.
that David my servant might have light away before me in Jerusalem,
mm-hmm.
the city which I have chosen me to put my name there.
Now read verse 38.
God on one con. Verse 38. And it shall be, if thou wilt hearken unto all that I command thee.
If you listen to all that I command thee, this is the Lord. We keep reading.
And will walk in my ways.
And walk in your own ways.
And walk in my ways.
The ways of the other nations.
And walk in my ways.
See, this is the criteria to receive the blessings that the Lord has for you. You got to walk in all of his ways. Keep reading.
And do that is right in my sight.
Mm-hmm.
To keep my statutes,
mm-hmm.
and my commandments.
Mm-hmm.
As David my servant did.
Right. Keep reading.
That I will be with thee and will build thee a sure house. As I have built for David, and will give Israel unto thee.
That's the stipulations. So what do you have to do? Just like in Deuteronomy 15 and 1. It will come to pass, if you hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, and observe to do all these commandments and statutes that I command thee this day, all these blessings will be given unto thee. That's what the Lord is saying again. So when you don't do that, then all of these curses will come upon you. You understand? Now, we'll be done with that reverse. Where you at right now?
Salakia, right now I am at verse 39.
Good. Start at 42. Read 42 and 43.
Count it on one count. Book of 1 Kings, chapter 11, verse 42. In the time that Solomon reigned in Jerusalem over all Israel was 40 years.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 43.
So Solomon ruled from a young man to a grown man. He got the kingdom when he was very young. And he had it for 40 years. Read.
Verse 43. And Solomon slept with his fathers.
Now this is Solomon's death. He's dead. He's sleeping with his fathers.
Mm-hmm. And was buried in the city of David, his father.
Mm-hmm.
And Rehoboam, his son, reigned in his stead.
So you hadn't even heard about Rehoboam. We just talked about Jeroboam. And the blessing that the Lord gave him was the northern kingdom, the 10 tribes. All right? Now let's go to 2 Chronicles. Let's go to 2 Chronicles. Let's go to 9 and 31. Let's start at 9 and 31. Just to see what we're still picking up from where we left off. That's all we're doing.
The book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 9, verse 31.
Mm-hmm.
And Solomon slept with his fathers.
So now I'm just showing you that we're starting right where we left off in Kings. Solomon is sleeping with his fathers. Read.
And he was buried in the city of David, his father.
Mm-hmm.
and Rehoboam his son reigned in his stead.
So now we right back where we left off. Next chapter, verse 1.
2 Chronicles chapter 10, verse 1. Mm-hmm. And Rehoboam went to Shechem, mm-hmm. for Shechem was all Israel come to make him king.
Okay, keep reading.
Verse 2. And it came to pass when Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, was in Egypt.
Start at verse 4.
Kind of the one kind. Book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 10, verse 4.
Yeah.
Thy father made our yoke grievous.
All right, so now the people is talking to Jeroboam. They're like, look, man, all right, you the king. So this is how you can get the people to listen to you. You know what I'm saying? Your father made it hard for us. Keep reading.
Kind of the one kind. Now, therefore, ease thou somewhat the grievous servitude of thy father.
So they're like, you know, calm down a little bit. Get off the gas.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all been thrashing on us. And if you do that, keep reading.
And his heavy yoke that he put upon us, and he will serve thee.
If you take this heavy yoke off us, then we'll serve you willingly. You know what I'm saying? We don't mind serving you and doing what it is you tell us to do. But damn. You know what I'm saying? Drop down to verse 7.
Count out of one kind. Book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 10, verse 7. And they spake unto him, saying, if thou be kind to his people and please them, and speak good words to them, they will be thy servants forever.
He like, look, man, the old, this is the counsel that he taking with, matter of fact, read verse 6 so we can see who's talking.
Count out of one kind.
Read verse 6.
It's a book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 10, verse 6. And King Rehoboam took counsel with old men that he had stood before Solomon, his father, while he yet lived, saying, what counsel give ye me to return an answer to this people?
So Solomon talking to some old men, some men that they used to give his father counsel. You know what I mean? These older guys used to give his father counsel. And now let's see what he said. Read verse 7 now. This is what the old man said to him. Read.
And they spake unto him, saying, if thou be kind to his people and please them and speak good words to them, they will be thy servants forever.
So they was like, look, man, just take the load off of us a little bit, and then we'll listen to you. You know what I mean? We'll do whatever you need us to do. Keep reading.
Verse 8. But he forsook the counsel.
He listened to him.
But he forsook the counsel.
He ain't trying to hear nothing them old men was saying. Read.
Which the old man gave him,
mm-hmm.
and took counsel with the younger men.
He went holler at his partners. He was like, man, forget what them old niggas talking about. Look, this, what you think we need to do? You know what I'm saying? Some niggas that ain't never done nothing, they ain't never been in charge of nothing. He went and talked to some knuckleheads.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That sound like Judah.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Judah, we ain't trying to hear nothing. We like, man, I'm in charge. What you want to do? You know what I'm saying? That's what was happening. You understand? Keep reading. You finished with verse 8?
Lie.
Okay, go ahead.
Kind of the one kind. That were brought up with him, mm-hmm. that stood before him.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 9. And he said unto them, what advice give ye that we may return answer to this people, which have spoken to me, saying, ease somewhat yoke that thy father has put upon us.
All they want is just a little ease, you know what I'm saying? Because Solomon had them working hard. Drop down to 14.
God,
we got a lot of reading to do today, so I just want to get the points out of here. Go ahead.
Verse 14. And answer them, saying, advice of young men, saying, my father made your yoke heavy.
So this is the advice the young men gave Jeroboam. He like, my father made your yoke heavy, but what? Read.
But I will add thereto.
But I'm going to add to it. Keep reading.
My father chastised you with whips,
mm-hmm.
but I chastise you with scorpions.
He like, look, y'all thought my father was a fool. I'm going to show you a fool.
Right.
Just like a Judah. You know what I'm saying? We just got to go ahead and flex. We got to take it to the limit. So that's what was, so now they looking at him like, oh, this young buck here, he going to kill us. We ain't finna listen to him. We ain't trying to hear nothing he's saying. You know what I'm talking about? All right. So now, go to, what verse are we at?
I'm at 15.
So read verse 15.
Come on, one kind. So the king hearkened not unto the people, for the cause was of God,
mm-hmm.
that the Lord might perform his word,
mm-hmm.
which he spake by the hand of Ahijah, the...
Ahijah.
Ahijah,
The Shilonite.
The Shilonite to Jeroboam, the son of Nebat.
All right. So all of this, his hardened heart that he had, was because the Lord wanted his heart to be hardened. And this split had to happen. This is prophecy. You know what I mean? So now read verse 16.
Don't one kind. And when all of Israel saw the king would not hearken unto them, the people answered the king, saying, what portion have we in David? And we have no inheritance in the son of Jesse. Every man to your tents, O Israel. And now, David, see thy own house. So all Israel went into their tents.
So Israel, the northern kingdom, is like, what do we got to do with this? These young bucks, these Judites, they got inheritance coming. We ain't got nothing. Okay, I know what to do. You understand? Now they finna separate. Go to chapter 11, verse 1.
Come on the wrong time. Book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 11, verse 1. And when Rehoboam was come to Jerusalem, he gathered of the house of Judah and Benjamin 144,000 chosen men.
To what?
Which were warriors to fight against Israel.
See, now, you know what's about to happen? A civil war. They're like, oh, so y'all trying to pack up and leave? Y'all trying to separate the kingdom? Well, we going to kill y'all then. Because if you're not for us, you're against us.
Right.
If you're not unified with us, then you're an enemy of us. That's the same thing we say to this day in the UPK. If you're not in the ISUPK, you are not in the truth.
Damn right.
We are not affiliated with these other groups.
Damn right.
It's the same. It's the same exact thing. It's the same spirit. Keep reading.
That he might bring the kingdom again to Rehoboam.
Verse 2. Draw down to verse 4.
Count on one count. Verse 4. Thus says the Lord, ye shall not go up, nor fight against your brethren.
Look, don't fight against your brother, man. Keep reading.
Return every man to his house, for this thing is done of me.
The reason they leaving is because I want them to leave. I prophesied that this was going to happen because of the wickedness of your father. Keep reading.
Count on the one come. For this thing is done of me, and obey the words of the Lord, and returned from going against Jeroboam.
So they was like, all right, cut out of one cut. You know what I'm saying? They calmed down, they sat down somewhere, and they didn't go smash on them. Now give me Zechariah 11 and 14. Because it was about to go down. It was about to be northern kingdom and southern kingdom in a civil war. That is how majority of the lands... That's how they all fall, through civil war, fighting against each other. And that's what we still doing to this day, fighting against our own brothers, hating our own brothers.
Right.
Read that.
Count on one kind. It's the book of Zechariah, chapter 11, verse 14. Then I cut asunder my other staff, even bands, that I might break the brotherhood between Judah and Israel.
The brotherhood was broken. You understand? Because we did go to civil war. We did fight. We did not unite anymore. You understand? Go back to 2 Chronicles 13. We're going to start at 15. Read that.
Book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 13, verse 15. Then the men of Judah gave a shout. And as the men of Judah shouted, it came to pass that God smote Jeroboam and all of Israel before Abijah.
Now.
And Judah.
After this, and let me tell you what happened in between that. What happened in between that was, you know, Jeroboam had kind of got big-headed. He wanted to fight. You know, he wanted to come up against him. So the Lord was like, I done already told y'all to chill. I done already spared you once. So just what you want to do? All right. So now they go ahead and have this fight. But the Lord is on the southern kingdom side. He not on the northern kingdom side. Because they was in the wrong spirit. So keep reading.
Come on, one come. Verse 16. And the children of Israel fled before Judah. And God delivered them into their hands.
And smashed them. Keep reading.
And Abijah and his people slew them with great slaughter. So there fell down slain of Israel 500,000 chosen men. Verse 18. Thus the children of Israel were brought under at that time, and the children of Judah prevailed, because they relied upon the Lord God of their fathers.
So what happened was, they went, the northern kingdom went, and they went into slavery under the Assyrians. You understand? They went into slavery under Assyrians. They went off and enslaved by the Assyrians. Then the Assyrians got taken over by the Grecians. And the Grecian, well, we're not going to move that fast. But that's what happened when the split happened. You understand? Now let's go to Ezekiel 37. Ezekiel 37. Now we finna get into some, to how we gonna come back together. We finna break it all the way down for you. Ezekiel 37, start at verse 15.
Ganawaka. Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 15. The word of the Lord came again to me, saying, verse 16, moreover, thou son of man, take thee one stick and write upon it for Judah.
So now this is a prophecy of us coming back together. Now, it never had nothing to do with everybody else. Never. It was always about our family being reunited.
That's right.
Because we were split. Because of this civil war that happened, the Lord wanted to bring us back together. So he said, take on you, he said, get you one stick and write upon it for what?
For Judah.
For Judah. Keep reading.
And for the children of Israel, his companions.
Keep reading.
Then take another stick and write upon it for Joseph. The stick of Ephraim.
Right.
For all those of the house of Israel and his companions.
So he was like, get you a stick, write Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. This is Judah's companion. Then he said, get you another stick for Ephraim and write on his companion. Manasseh, Naphtali, Asher, Issachar, you know what I'm saying? Reuben, Gad, all these other tribes. And what did he say to do after that?
God of the one kind. Verse 17. And join them one to another into one stick.
And join them one to another to one stick. Unify them. Bring them back together because they were split up. That's what this entire Bible is about.
That's right.
This entire Bible is to bring the oppressed, the disobedient, back together in righteousness. This ain't got nothing to do with nobody else. This ain't got nothing to do with the white man, the Arab, the Chinese. This entire Bible, from Genesis to Revelations, is about us coming back together with our brothers.
Right.
Keep reading.
God on one kind. And they shall become one in thy hand.
They're going to become two.
They shall become one in thy hand.
Everybody in the world gonna become one.
They shall become one in thy hand.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans will become one again. The Lord said it. And he's not a man that he should lie.
Damn right.
Keep reading.
God of the one come. Verse 18. And when the children of thy people shall speak unto thee, saying, will that not show us what thou meanest by these?
He was like, so what are you trying to say? Because in Israel, once you were cast out, once you were gone, it was a wrap. So they kind of like, I feel what you're trying to say, but explain what you're saying. Read.
Come on, walk on. Verse 19. Saying to them, thus says the Lord God, behold, I will take the stick of Joseph, which is in the hand of Ephraim and all the tribes of Israel, his fellows.
Them 10 tribes.
And I will put them with the stick of Judah and make them one stick, that they shall be one in my hand.
That's what this entire, that's what Christ coming was for. That's what everything that you think about dealing with this Bible is all about. It's all about bringing the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom back together. Keep reading.
Come on, verse 20. And the sticks whereon thou writest shall be in thy hand before their eyes. Verse 21. And say unto them, thus says the Lord God, behold, I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen.
I will take the children of Israel, the northern kingdom, from among the heathen. Read.
Whether they be gone, and will gather them on every side and bring them into their own land.
That's the kingdom of heaven. He's going to gather us from every land that we've scattered into our own land. This ain't got nothing to do with the white man, the Arabs, the Chinese. This is only talking to the children of Israel.
That's right.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Keep reading.
Verse 22. And I will make them one nation.
He going to do what?
And I will make them one nation.
Keep reading.
In the land upon the mountains of Israel.
Keep reading.
And one king shall be king to them all.
We know who that is. That is Yahweh Shah.
God of the one kind.
Keep reading.
And thou shalt be no more two nations.
We're not going to be separate. This ain't said there'll be no more 18 nations. It said there'll be no more two nations. In the New Testament, the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom had not come together. This prophecy had not been fulfilled. So Christ came only to bring back these two nations to be one again.
Damn right.
Because he died for his people. Keep reading.
God of the one come. Neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms anymore at all.
At all. Ever again. That's the kingdom of heaven. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native American being joined together. Keep reading.
Verse 23. Neither shall they defile themselves anymore with their idols.
Mm. Read.
Nor with their detestable things.
Mm-hmm.
Nor any of their transgressions. But I will save them out of all their dwelling places wherein they have sinned. And will cleanse them, and shall be, and they shall be my people, and I shall be their God.
Man, this said that they're not going to be serving their idols no more. They're going to put away the detestable things. It said that they're going to be my people, and I will be their God. Right? Now let's go to Jeremiah 31 and 31. This is what the Bible is talking about. Here in the Israelite School of Universal and Practical Knowledge, we teach the truth out of the Bible. We don't teach what we like, what it feels like, you know, what we want it to be. We teach what the Bible actually says. Read that.
God on the one comes, the book of Jeremiah, chapter 31, verse 31. Behold, the days come, says the Lord. Mm-hmm. I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah.
Now, he said, I'm going to make a new covenant, meaning there was an old covenant that they did not keep. It's like, how can I put this for you to understand? Like, probation. Can somebody that's not on probation violate their probation?
Can someone that has
a clean record violate probation? No. The only way you can violate probation is if you're on probation.
Right.
Well, sin is the transgression of the law. If the law was never given to you, you can't sin. You can't break the law.
Right.
The only people that can break the law are the people that the law were given to, which is the Israelites. Because in the wilderness, the law was only given to Israel. There was no Arabs. There was no Chinese. There was no Africans. We just left Egypt. You know, there were no Egyptians in the wilderness with us.
Right.
So the covenant was not given to no one but us. So how is it that anyone else could sin or break the covenant? Boom. Mind blown. No one else can.
Damn right.
No one else can sin or break the covenant. Only we can, because the law was only given to us. We're the ones under probation. So he said, I'm going to make a new covenant. The new covenant, meaning if I go to a car dealership and I say, I like this car right here. I want to try to get it. They're not going to say, let me give you a new application. Because this is my first time trying to get this car.
Right.
They're going to just give me an application. The only way they give me a new application is if I messed up the old one. The new covenant is because they broke the old one.
That's right.
That's only to the people that's under that covenant, which is the Blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Right.
No one else. Keep reading.
God on one come. Verse 32. Not according to the covenant I made with their fathers in the day that I took them and by the hand to bring them out the land of Egypt,
mm-hmm.
which my covenant they break.
They what?
Which my covenant they break.
That's what I just got through explaining. They broke that covenant, so they had to get a new one. They messed up on that application, so they had to get another one.
Right.
Keep reading.
God on the one come. Although I was a husband unto them, says the Lord.
Although I was a provider unto them, a protector, someone that loved them, they broke it. So I had to make another one. Because marriage is forever.
Right.
The Lord put us away for a while. He separated from us. He moved out the house with us, but he's still our husband. He's still our provider. He's still our caregiver, our caretaker.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Keep reading.
John out of one come, verse 33. But it shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord.
Now, did he say he going to make this covenant with everybody on the face of the earth, with the ants, the dogs, the elephants, the Chinese, the whites, the everybody? No. He said he's only making this covenant with the house of Israel. This is the new covenant that they're talking about, but it don't say nothing about everybody.
Right.
The only people that try to put everybody into that covenant is your pastor.
Damn right.
And the white man, because he know it has nothing to do with him.
Right.
He reading.
Count on the one gun. I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, says the Lord, I will put my law in their inward parts.
You're going to put my laws where?
In their inward parts.
I'm going to put it in your mind. You're going to live it. The problem with them back in the Bible time, they wasn't living it. They wasn't trying to keep the law. They were just trying to get by with it. Oh, I got to sacrifice a sheep if I do this. Well, that's cool. I just had 5 new sheep. They just had babies.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Old Bessie, she's just going to have to go.
Line them up.
I got to line them up because I got to do it, man. I got to do it. That's how. It wasn't in us. It wasn't like, man, nah, I'm not doing that. Because the Lord said not to do it. You know what I'm saying?
Damn right.
It's more personal. It's something I have to do. He put it in our inward parts. Keep reading.
Down on the one con. And write it in their hearts.
Writing it in our hearts. Keep reading.
And will be their God, and they shall be my people.
It's the same thing we just read over there. That we are his people because we keep the commandments. Keep reading.
God out of one con, verse 34. And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor, and even every man his brother, saying, know the Lord, for they shall know me. For the least of them unto the greatest of them, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more.
That's the new covenant that everybody looking for. You don't believe me? Give me Hebrews 8 and 8. Now we just read it out of the Old Testament. Now we're going precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little.
Damn right.
Start at 8. Read that.
God out of one kind. This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 8, verse 8. For finding fault with them, he saith, behold, the days come, saith the Lord.
Wait, did he say finding fault with everybody?
Finding fault with them.
With them.
He says, behold, the days come, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel.
Wait, did he say he's going to make a new covenant with the earth?
A new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah.
That's it. That's who this is for. This ain't got nothing to do with you, white man. You in heaven right now.
Damn right.
Enjoy yourself. Go out and get that money, man. Go out and rob a bank. You ain't going to go to jail anyway. Go have fun. Do all it is that you want to do. You know what I'm saying? When I came to the truth, it really made more sense to me about how this is the white man kingdom, being that he's a cave beast. And everything out here is cement. Because that's his natural state. That's what he's used to. He's used to living in rock. So all these buildings are built off of stone, cement, rock. Go ahead.
And they want to throw us in the concrete jungle.
And they want to. Because they are the ones that belong in the concrete jungle. You understand? Keep reading.
Count on the one con. Book of Hebrews chapter 8, verse 9. Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day I took them by the hand and led them out of the land of Egypt.
That's the same thing he just said in Jeremiah. This is only talking to the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Right.
Keep reading.
Because they continue not in my covenant, I have regarded them not, says the Lord.
The Lord said, I'm just trying to stomp it in the ground that this ain't for nobody else. Keep reading.
God out of one kind. Verse 10. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel.
He gonna make it with the white man and everybody on the planet.
This is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord.
Keep reading.
I will put my laws into their mind.
This is the same thing we just read in Jeremiah. Keep reading.
And write them in their hearts.
Mm-hmm.
And I will be them a God, and they shall be to me my people.
Right, do you see any other nation out here other than Judah and Israel?
Nah.
Because he's bringing one stick into another and bringing them together, like we read in Ezekiel.
Right.
That is the new covenant. Because once you left the covenant, you were kicked out, you were cast out, you were gone. You were called a Gentile.
Damn right.
You missed one Passover, you were called a Gentile. You missed a feast day, you didn't get your child circumcised, you were called a Gentile. No matter if your blood is Israel, no matter if you Northern Kingdom, ain't coming to the, I ain't see you at the Passover.
Right.
What you doing up here? You a Gentile.
Damn right.
That's, we still do that. We still do that to this day. We see black people that's not from our hood, then you are a stranger.
Damn right.
You ain't from my hood, so you a stranger in my hood.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's the same. This is black people. You feel me? You can't put it no other way.
Right.
You know him? Nope. Now, this brother black like you? This nigga got the same swag you got? All that. You know him? Hell no, I don't know him. What that nigga doing over here? He don't belong over here. He's a stranger.
Right.
Same thing. So the Southern Kingdom was looking at the Northern Kingdom like, what they doing over here? What they trying to do? You understand? Keep reading.
God on one gun. Verse 11. And they shall not teach every man his neighbor and every man his brother, saying, know the Lord. For all shall know me from the least to the greatest.
I just want you to see that. It's the exact same thing we read in Jeremiah in the New Testament. It's ain't gonna do with nobody else.
That's right.
Now we're gonna go more into the details of the Northern Kingdom. Let's go to the Apocrypha. Give me 1 Maccabees chapter 1. Start at 1 and 1. It's in the back. We're going to show it to you. I'm trying to prove it to you without a shadow of a doubt that the Gentiles in the New Testament are Israelites. Understand? I seen some devil on here earlier talking about, I ain't even read it. I just seen words like Ruth, the Moabite, and the Moabite and all of that. The Moabite that it was talking about, she was an Israelite. You know what I'm saying?
So like it referred to her as Moabitish.
Exactly. She was an Israelite. They called, what was Elijah? They called him Tishite. So you're going to say that Elijah wasn't an Israelite because he called him a Tishite? You just called him the landmass that he lived in, just like you call yourself an African-American black people.
Right.
And he was an Israelite. Anybody in this Bible that has a book is an Israelite. No heathen get no shine in our book.
Damn right.
That's, I ain't got time for that today. All right, so let's go. Let's keep reading.
Start at one. This is the first book of Maccabees in the Apocrypha, chapter 1, verse 1. And it happened after that Alexander, son of Philip the Macedonian, who came out of the land of Shittim and smitten Darius, the king of Persia, of Medes, that he reigned in his stead for over Greece.
He reigned in his
stead. The first over Greece.
The first, right? Matter of fact, drop down to, let me see what it said. Let's drop down to verse 4. Read that too.
God of one con, verse 4. And he gathered a mighty strong host and ruled over countries and nations and kings who became tributaries unto him.
Now, we go to Daniel. Hold that. Go to Daniel 8 and 20.
Got on one cup.
Yeah, that's right. Daniel 8 and 20. We're going to show it to you. Yeah, Daniel 8 and 20. That's right. We're going to show it to you out of this Bible that this is a history book. Everybody know about Alexander the Great. You know what I'm saying? Now, we finna show it to you. Keep reading.
This is the book of Daniel, chapter 8, verse 20. The ram, which thou sawest having two horns, are the kings of Media and Persia.
Or what?
Or the kings of
Medes?
Meat.
Oh, you're right. Media. That's what I said right there.
Okay. Media and Persia. Verse 21. And the rough goat is the king of Grecia.
It's the who?
It's the king of Grecia.
Now, Daniel was having a vision. He had a dream. You know what I'm saying? And he's talking about the different rulerships. You know what I'm saying? This is in Daniel. In the Maccabees, this goat, this ram popped up, which was, go to 1 Maccabees 10. 1 Maccabees 10. We're going to start at 41.
Start on one cup.
Yeah.
This is the book of 1 Maccabees, chapter 10, verse 41. And all the overplus.
Hold up. So, lucky. I messed up. I think it's 1 and 10. It's 1 and 10, Salakia. 1 Maccabees 1 and 10.
The book of 1 Maccabees, chapter 1, verse 10. And there came out of them the wicked root, Antiochus, surname
Epiphanes. Antiochus Epiphanes.
Antiochus, surname Epiphanes.
That's in history.
Gone to one come.
We see in Alexander the Great, and we're seeing Antiochus Epiphanes in the Bible. Keep reading.
Son of Antiochus the king, who had reigned hostage at Rome, and he reigned in the 137 years of the kingdom of the Greeks.
Keep reading.
Verse 11.
Now, hold up, Salakia. This is the same. Now, what you don't understand is when these white people start getting into rulership, that's when they start making us fight. And, they start making us fight in them Colosseums. That's when the sports started. You know what I'm saying? That's when they started taking us away from being priests.
Right.
And making it unlawful for us to be Jews. You know what I'm saying? They start killing us if we claimed our nationality. Keep reading.
Come on, one come. In those days, they went out of Israel wicked men who persuaded many, saying, let us go make a covenant with the heathen that are round about us.
Now, these some coons. These are your brothers. That's like, look, let's go unite ourselves to these heathens. You know what I'm saying? That are round about us. Keep reading.
God of one come. For since we departed from them, we have had much sorrow.
Since we've left, that's just like in Egypt. When they left out of Egypt, they was like, man, we need to go back because we was built off in Egypt.
Damn right.
It's the same thing. When it started getting hard, them coons pop up like, man, let's just go back and just kiss ass for the rest of our life.
Right.
But the Bible said, live not a beggar's life, for it's better for you to die than to beg.
Damn right.
We are princes and princesses. We don't have to beg nobody for nothing.
Right.
You understand? Keep reading.
Gone on to one con. Verse 12. So this device pleased them well. Verse 13. Then certain of people were so forward herein that they went to the king who gave them license to do after the ordinance of the heathen.
Drop down to 41. God, the ordinance of the heathen. Now they sold us out to the heathen. Now we acting like them. We doing what they do. Read verse 41.
Verse 41. Moreover, King
Antiochus
wrote to his whole kingdom that all should be one people.
All should be who?
One people.
What does that sound like? That sounds like America to me.
Damn right.
Everybody should come together and be one people. And this is why the Northern Kingdom is over here. The Northern Kingdom is in this land. And they telling them, we should all be one people. Keep reading.
God out of one con. Verse 42. And everyone should leave his laws.
Everyone should do what?
Everyone should leave his laws.
We should come up with a one world religion. You know what that one world religion is today?
Damn right.
Christianity.
Damn right.
Keep reading.
God out of one kind. So all the heathens agreed according to the commandment of the king.
The commandment of the Lord.
The commandment of the king.
Keep reading.
God out of one kind. Verse 43. Yea, many also of the Israelites consented to his religion.
To this culture.
Consented to his religion.
To who? To the Lord's belief.
Consented to his religion.
To this white man's religion. This is when religion crept into your life, black people.
Right.
Keep reading.
And sacrifice unto his idols.
Mm. Keep reading.
And profane the Sabbath.
And profane the Sabbath. Keep reading.
Verse 44. For the king has sent letters by messenger into Jerusalem and the cities of Judah, that they may follow the strange.
Like, not only was they trying to do this for the northern kingdom, now they sent it to where the Judahites were. Now, I got the northern kingdom doing what I want them to do. Now I'm finna send message over to where Judah had so they can get down too.
Right.
Keep reading.
Verse 45. And forbid burnt offerings.
Oh, so now, it's forbidden. For something to be forbidden means if you do it, you're going to pay for it.
Right.
Keep reading.
God out of one kind. And sacrifice.
Mm-hmm.
And drink offerings in the temple.
Can't do none of the things that you're supposed to do anymore. Keep reading.
And that they should profane the Sabbath and festival days.
They gonna profane the feast days. Keep reading.
God on one kind. 36. And pollute the sanctuary and holy people.
Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
Verse 47. Set up altars and groves and chapels of idols and sacrifice swine flesh and unclean beasts.
They sacrificing things that would never be in our temple. Things that couldn't even make it through the... things we couldn't even touch. They sacrificing it in the temple, man. Keep reading.
Kanamakam, verse 48. That they should also leave their children uncircumcised.
So now you... everything that the Lord said to do, they tell you not to do. The white man was like, y'all gonna circumcise? Yeah, don't do that either. Feast days, don't do that either. Y'all go sacrifice pigs. Can y'all sacrifice pigs? Y'all can't? Good. We gonna sacrifice pigs. The Sabbath day. Y'all keep the Sabbath holy? Don't keep it holy no more. And if I see you doing it, I'ma kill you. That's the white man. That's the life you live right now. Everything the Lord say to do, he tell you is lawful. Be a homosexual. You're not supposed to be a homosexual. Be a homosexual. You can't eat pork, crab, shrimp, and lobster. It's a delicacy. Eat it. Christmas, Thanksgiving, 4th of July, all that is pagan. You ain't supposed to do it. Easter, do it. It's the same thing. Keep reading.
Turn on one kind. And make their souls abominable with all manner of uncleanness and profanation.
That's what the white man did. He made our souls abominable. The Lord hates abomination. The Lord kills over abomination. And he made our souls abominable. You understand? He destroyed. They destroyed us. That's why the white man's the goddamn devil.
That's right.
Keep reading.
Verse 49. To the end, they might forget the law and change all the ordinance.
That they might keep the law.
That they might forget the law and change all the ordinance.
That's what happened. We forgot the law. We forgot what we supposed to do, and they changed everything that was regular to us. Our regular way of life, they changed it to wickedness. Keep reading.
Verse 50.
Mm-hmm.
And whosoever would not do according to the commandment of the king, he said, he should die.
He should what?
He should die.
It was a life or death decision to be obedient to the Most High or follow the white man. Because if you listen to the white man, he was going to kill you.
Right.
I mean, yeah, if you listen to the white man, the Lord was going to kill you. And if you listen to the Lord, the white man was going to kill you. But the scriptures say, fear not the one that can hurt the body, but fear the one that can destroy the soul in hell.
Right.
You are living in hell right now.
Damn right.
And the Lord can destroy you. You understand that? And that means 2 Maccabees 6 and 6. Trying to squash the fat, squash anything that makes you feel like the Gentiles. See, what's crazy is they had to take this Apocrypha out of the Bible.
Right.
Because they got all this history in it. They had to snatch that out of there. Because if they would have kept this Apocrypha in there, it wouldn't be no way, no how you would think that the Gentiles that are in the New Testament are not Israelites.
Damn right.
The only reason you think that is because they took the Apocrypha out of the Bible. Read that.
It's the book of 2 Maccabees, chapter 6, verse 6. Neither was it lawful for a man to keep the Sabbath days or ancient feasts.
Hold up, start at verse 4 real fast so we can get the understanding of what was happening at the time.
Kind of a long time. This is the book of 2 Maccabees, chapter 6, verse 4. For the temple was filled with riot and revealing by the Gentiles, who have dallied with harlots.
So they in the temple messing with harlots, messing with hoes, prostitutes in the temple. Keep reading.
And had to do with women within the circuit of the holy places.
Keep reading.
And besides that, brought in things that were not lawful.
Like the pork, like the pigs. So they in the temple messing with prostitutes and got pig in the temple. Keep reading.
Kadawanka, verse 5. The altar was also filled with profane things, which the law forbiddeth.
Keep reading.
Verse 6. Neither was it lawful for a man to keep the Sabbath days or ancient feasts or to profess himself at all to be a Jew.
That was against the law to say that you were a Jew. You would be killed for saying that you were a Jew. Read verse 8.
God on one con, verse 8. Moreover, there went out a decree to the neighboring cities of the heathen by suggestion of Ptolemy.
Ptolemy, another name in history that you all hear about. Keep reading.
Against the Jews, that they should observe the same fashions and be partakers of their sacrifice.
That's why you gotta stand up for the damn national anthem. Because you gotta partake in their sacrifices and the things they want you to do. You can't follow what you want to follow. You got to follow what they want you to do.
Right.
Keep reading.
God on one con. Verse 9. Whosoever would not conform themselves to the manner of the Gentiles should be put to death.
Should be doing what?
Should be put to death.
Keep reading.
Then might a man have seen the present misery.
Keep reading. Now, let me tell you what was happening to people who did not listen to this. Read the next verse.
Verse 10. For there were two women brought who had circumcised their children.
So they like, man, forget this white man. I'm going to keep the law.
Right.
They got their kids circumcised. Read.
Whom when they had openly led round about the city, the babes hanging at their breasts, they cast them down headlong from the wall.
They seen these kids out there circumcised with no turtlenecks hanging off their rods.
Right.
Got them kids and threw them head first off over the wall. You know, other people are like, oh, they doing that if you're not keeping the law? Man, I can't. I mean, the Lord understand. The Lord know my heart. Keep reading.
Count on the one count, verse 11. And others that had run together into caves nearby to keep the Sabbath day secretly, being discovered to Philip, were all burnt together because they made conscience to help themselves for the honor of the most sacred day.
So you trying to do what the Lord tell you to do. They kill you. They throw your kids over the walls. They burn you. They do all manner of wickedness because you trying to follow what the Lord wants you to do.
Right.
You going through persecution. We were going through persecution. So it was unlawful for us to call ourselves Jews. So what did we have to be called? Greeks. We were called Greeks. You understand? That's what you see in the New Testament. Now, that's why you see in, go to Galatians 3 and 28. That's why you see this said. It don't say nothing else about nobody else. It just says these two different people. And people don't recognize that when they read that. Galatians 3 and 28. You don't understand that when you read that, this scripture, that you don't see it talking about no other nationality of people. It just said neither Jew nor Greek. Why is that? I'm about to show you why. Read that.
It's the book of Galatians, chapter 3, verse 28. There is neither Jew nor Greek.
Mm-hmm.
There is neither bond nor free.
Mm-hmm.
There is neither male nor female.
Mm-hmm.
For ye are all one in Christ Jesus.
That's the Christian go-to scripture right there. The reason that we were called Greeks is because we were Hellenized. If you look up this word Greek in the Hebrew, it is Hellenist. You know what I want. I think I can find it before you. Here you go.
God.com. This is Hellenist out of the Zondervan Pictorial Bible Dictionary. Jews who made Greek their tongue.
Everybody who made Greek their tongue.
Jews who made Greek their tongue.
When it said neither Jew nor Greek, it's talking about the Jews that made Greek their tongue. It ain't talking about everybody.
Right.
Talking about white. It ain't talking about no Chinese people who made Greek their tongue. This is only for us. Keep reading.
God of the one kind. And with it, often adopted Greek ideas and practices.
Greek ideas and practices. So we start following their feast days, their customs, their sacrifices. We start doing all the things that they did to stay alive. We made Greek our tongue. We learned their languages. We learned everything that they taught us. Those are the Greeks in the New Testament. Those are the Gentiles in the New Testament that could be saved, because salvation has never been for no one else.
That's right.
But the Jews. I'm glad I just thought about that. Let me go to 2 Kings. Because a lot of people don't understand what happened with the Samaritan lady. So we're going to explain that too. Because that's going to help you understand a lot. Let me get 2 Kings 17. We're going to start at 22.
It's the book of 2 Kings, chapter 17, verse 22. For the children of Israel walked in all the sins of Jeroboam, which he did.
Mm-hmm.
They departed not from them.
Right. Keep going.
Verse 23. Until the Lord removed Israel out of his sight.
Mm-hmm.
As he had said by all his servants that the prophets, so was the Israel carried away out of their own land to Assyria until this day.
Israel, the northern kingdom, were carried out of their land to Assyria. Like I said earlier, they went into slavery under the Assyrians. You understand? They were carried out of their land into Assyria. Now, here you go. Keep reading.
Verse 24. And the king of Assyria brought the men from Babylon,
mm-hmm,
and from Kathah,
mm-hmm,
and from Avah,
mm-hmm,
and from Hamath,
mm-hmm,
from the Sepharvaim,
mm-hmm,
and placed them in cities of Samaria,
mm-hmm,
instead of the children of Israel.
Now, the Samaritans and these other nations were placed in our land.
Right.
Instead of Israel. So instead of us being in our own land, they took us to Assyria. And they put all these other nations in our land like we see today.
Damn right.
Right now, we have the white man. You got the they talk about Manessa just went back home and killed some goddamn Chinese people.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's the same thing that they were doing back then. It's happening. It's happened right now. Keep reading.
And they possessed Samaria and dwelt in the cities thereof.
So they in our land. Well, so now we in their land. They're in our land. Now, watch this. Read next
verse. Counter to one kind, verse 25. And so it was that the beginning of their dwelling there that they feared not the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Fearing the Lord meaning not, they don't know the laws. They can't. The beginning of wisdom is to fear the Lord, to be obedient, to keep his commandments.
Right.
They wasn't following the law because they didn't know him. So, what happened?
Therefore the Lord sent lions among them,
mm-hmm,
which slew some of them.
Now, they in our land not being right, Lord sent lions, and they just start eating them up. Read the next verse.
Deuteronomy 1:26. Wherefore they spake to the king of Assyria, saying, the nations which thou hast removed and placed in the cities of Samaria know not the manner of the God of the land.
They don't know how to keep the land pure without getting smashed on. Keep reading.
Therefore, he has sent lions among them.
He's saying what?
He has sent lions among them.
Keep going.
And behold, they slay them because they know not manner of the God of the land.
The God of the land. They in our land. The Lord destroyed them for being there. Keep reading.
God on the one con, verse 27. Then the king of Assyria commanded thee, saying, carry thither one of the priests whom ye brought from thence, and let them go dwell there.
So now he gives them our priests to go and teach the Samaritans our ways, these Ethiopians, our ways. And we still to this day see Ethiopians that claim to be Jews. You know why? Because they know not what they worship. Keep reading. Keep reading.
And let him teach them the manner of the God of the land.
They had to do that so they could survive on the land so they wouldn't get killed.
Right.
That ain't got nothing to do with them being a part of the fold. Keep reading.
God on the one come, verse 28. Then one of the priests whom they have carried away from Samaria came and dwelt in Bethel and taught them how they should fear the Lord.
Now, let's go to John 4:20. Because people read this and be like, well, what about the lady at the well? What about her? We finna show you. Read it.
God on the one come. It's the book of John. Chapter 4, verse 20. Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where we ought to worship.
Now, this Ethiopian is talking to Christ, and she's like, my fathers worship in this mountain. But you saying this, you trying to tell me this ain't my place to worship, but shoot, all of my ancestors is from here because you were placed in this land.
Right.
It's not your homeland. Keep reading.
Verse 21. Jesus said unto her, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father.
It's going to come a time where you ain't going to be here. You are your people. Keep reading.
Verse 22. Ye worship ye not what?
Read that again.
Salakia. Ye worship ye not what?
Ye worship ye know not what. You don't know what you're worshiping. Keep reading.
We know what we worship.
We know, though. Keep reading.
For salvation is of the Jews.
Salvation is for us, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. So these Ethiopians was in the land living there, and they thought that they were the people of the land. They thought that they was the Lord's chosen people. Christ came to her and told her, you don't even know what you're worshiping. You don't even know what you're doing. But we do, because this is for us.
Damn right.
This ain't got nothing to do with you. Keep reading.
God of one kind, verse 23. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Mm-hmm. For the Father seeketh such worship of him.
The Father seeketh worship from us, not from these other nations. Don't give a damn about them. He wants us to keep these laws, statutes, and commandments. So it's going to be a time when you ain't going to be in this land worshiping the Lord. Salvation is of the Jews. I had to get on that. Now, since we in John, let me go to John 7:35. Now we're going to start getting into the cuts. Now, if you ain't wrote down no scripture, it's time to start writing.
Right.
Because these are the Christian destroyers. Read that.
7:35, sir. God on one con. There's a book of John, chapter 7, verse 35. Then said the Jews among themselves, whether will he go?
Now, this southern kingdom is saying amongst themselves, where is he about to go?
Read. That we shall not find him. Will he go into the dispersed among the Gentiles?
The who?
Will he go into the dispersed among the Gentiles?
The dispersed. Who are the dispersed? That is the northern kingdom.
Damn right.
That is the other part of our family. They were like, so is he going to go to them other people that we cast away, that we didn't want to have nothing to do with? He didn't say, or is he going to go to everybody in the world? The dispersed amongst the Gentiles. That's who Christ talked to. That's who the disciples talked to. Because salvation is of the Jews. You understand? Let me get, before I go too deep, let me get Hosea. Hosea 2:23. Read that.
God on one kind. This is the book of Hosea, chapter 2, verse 23. And I will sow her unto me in the earth, and I will have mercy upon her that had not attained mercy. And I will say to them which were not my people, thou art my people, and they shall say, thou art my God.
Who is he talking to? He's talking to Israel.
Damn right.
Those people that were not his people are the northern kingdom. You know what I'm saying? But he's saying, I'm going to say to them that they are my people because now I made it to where they can come back to me because Christ died for his people. He died to bring the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom back to one.
That's right.
He died so that he can have one stick and another stick and put those sticks together as one, like in Ezekiel 37. That's what happened. It ain't had nothing to do with everybody else because it never had nothing to do with nobody else. Understand? Let's get the precept, Romans 9:24. We just seen it.
Book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 24. Even us, whom he hath called, not of the Jews only, but also the Gentiles. Verse 25. As he said, also in OC.
OC, which is Hosea. He said he called only, not only us, not only the Jews, but the Gentiles. As he said in OC, in Hosea. Read.
God on the one come. I will call them my people, which were not my people, and her beloved, which was not my beloved.
I'm going to call them people who were not my people. The northern kingdom, they were not my people because they were following after the Grecians.
Right.
Now I'm going to call them my beloved. You understand? It's all over the Bible. Let me get Acts 5:30. So wait, before we go there, let me get 2nd Ezra, so I can close out this Northern Kingdom 10 tribe stuff. 2nd Ezra 13:40. So I can close this out real fast. Read that.
God on the one kind. It's the book of Ezra in the 2nd Ezra in the Apocrypha. Chapter 13, verse 40.
Yeah.
Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea.
Yeah.
The king.
Say it again.
These are the 10 tribes which were carried out away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea, the king.
Keep reading.
Whom the Salmaneser, the king of Assyria, led away captive. And he carried them over the waters.
He carried them over the waters. Keep reading.
And so came they into another land.
They came into another land. People want to know, how did the Northern Americans, if they Israel, then why didn't they come over here with the black people, the right. slaves from Africa? Well, this is because they were in Assyria and they went into another land. Keep reading.
God on one kind, verse 42, that they might there keep their statues, which they never kept in their own land.
They kept their statues that they never kept in their own land. Now they're ready to be obedient. Now they're ready to do right. Keep reading.
And they entered into the Euphrates by the narrow passages of the river.
Keep reading.
For verse 44. For the Most High then showed them signs from them, and he held still the flood till they were passed over.
Until they were passed over. The Lord held back the floods. This is how they got over to this land. Keep reading.
Verse 45. For through the country there was a great way to go, namely of year and a half.
Mm-hmm.
In the same region is called
Acereth. Now, this is how Christopher Columbus found the Northern Kingdom. This is how he found them, through reading our records. This is how he knew where to go. Right. So he knew if he sailed this way for a year and a half, he would run into a new land. This is how it was found. Now, read this. Read the book. The name of the book.
Ghana the One Khan. The Early Origins of Literature.
Mm-hmm.
That the 10 tribes taken captain by Shalmaneser had escaped into the land Azareth. That Azareth was obviously near America, and some of the Jews had migrated to it.
What?
And some of the Jews have migrated to it.
Keep reading.
God of the One Khan. Similarities of certain Aztec words to Hebrew words, and by claiming both people of similar idolatries.
See, just cut all that. Acereth ain't America. They came over here. It's like them stopping in Canada, residing, and coming on down and conquering and taking over. When I conquering, we're just filling up and taking over the rest of the land. That's what happened. So that's the Northern Kingdom coming over here. So that starts the whole, that explains to you how they're our people. Because they just left before 70 AD. You know what I'm saying? They left before the shit hit the fan.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I just had to bring that out before we got too deep. Now, let's get back into, I really want to get into this prodigal son. Do you know what, do you remember what that said?
God of my God. It's like Luke 15, chapter 11 through.
Yeah, 32. Yeah. Let's go there. Now, let's see Christ talk about it. Prodigal son. Read that.
God of my God. It's the book of Luke, chapter 7, verse 11.
Is that right? I thought it was 15.
Sorry. Yeah. 15 through 30. You're right. God of the Walk.
15, start at 11, I think, huh? Yeah. Luke 15, starting at 11. Now, this is a story that people read, but they don't understand it. Read that.
God of the Walk. It's the book of Luke, chapter 15, verse 11.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, a certain man had two sons.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 12. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me a portion of goods that falleth to me.
Mm-hmm.
And he divided unto them his living.
Now, this is the Northern Kingdom. This is a parable that Christ is giving about the split. A father had two sons. One of the younger son, the Northern Kingdom, they like, man, give me my stuff and I'm leaving. So that's what he did. Read.
God of the One Khan. Verse 12. Verse 13. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country.
Mm-hmm.
And there was wasted his substance with righteous living.
Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
Verse 14. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in the land.
Mm-hmm.
And he began to be in want.
He never had to be in want before when he was following and doing what he was supposed to do. But when he went out and left his father, his protection, and started living like everybody else, he started to need things. Keep reading.
God of the One Khan, verse 15. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of a country, and he sent him into the fields to feed swine.
Mm-hmm. Now he got him out there working hard labor. You know what I'm saying? Keep reading.
Verse 16. And he would be fain and have filled his belly with the husk of the swine did eat.
He had to eat swine, which we would never eat. You understand? Keep reading.
And no man gave unto him. Verse 17.
Now, you see, this is showing you that this is talking about our people, because we would have never ate swine before we were put under this white man.
Right.
Now, we eating every damn part of the pig. We eating the damn chitlin, the intestines. Yes. We eating the pig feet. We eating everything out the pig. This is showing you who these people are. Nobody else is put on that swine like us.
Right.
Keep reading.
Verse 17. And when he came to him, himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father have bread enough to spare? I perish with hunger.
Mm-hmm. He like, my father's servants got more to spare. The servants of my father. Keep reading.
Verse 18, I will arise and go to my father,
mm-hmm.
and I will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven before thee.
See, this is the he that believe and he that is converted. You know what I'm saying? Believe on me. That's what this son was doing. He confessed his sins. He's like, man, I was wrong. I should have never done what I did. Keep reading.
Verse 19. And am no more worthy to be called thy son.
Mm-hmm.
Make me as one of thy hired servants.
He humbled himself. That's what the Most High wants from you. He wants you to humble yourself.
Right.
That's why I said that you must be taught again. You have to be taught again. You got to humble yourself. Everything you thought you knew, you got to be retaught because you've been taught straight lies.
Right.
Keep reading.
God out of one kind, verse 20. And he arose and came to his father. But when he was yet great way off, his father saw him.
Mm-hmm.
And had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him.
He was thinking that, man, when I go home, my daddy going to be pissed off at me. When his daddy saw him from afar, meaning his daddy was looking for him to come back one day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It wasn't, you know, he let him do what he wanted to do. He let him follow after the lust and the desires of his own heart.
Right.
But he knew eventually one day he was going to come back and need me. And when he came back with open arms. He was like, man, son, I've been waiting on you to come back, man. You know what I'm saying? Keep reading.
Verse 21. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son.
He was like, man, I'm out of there, daddy. I'm not even worthy to be called your son no more. Just look what his father said. Read.
Count out of one con. Verse 22. But the father said to his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him.
Mm-hmm.
Put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet.
He's like, boy, I ain't worried about that. I'm glad you called him.
Damn right.
Man, give him, man, keep reading.
Verse 23, and bring hither the fatted calf and kill it and let us eat and be merry.
He was like, man, let's turn up. The boy say, man, my boy back home, let's throw a party.
Damn right.
Keep reading.
Verse 24, for this my son was dead and is alive again.
My son was living in sin. And now he's come back to righteousness.
Damn right.
Keep reading.
Gone to one kind. He was lost and is found.
He was lost, but now he found. Read.
And they began to be merry.
Now, that's the northern kingdom coming back home. The father was accepting them. Now let's see what the next verse says.
Read. Gone to one kind. Verse 25. Now his elder son was in the field. And he came and drew nigh to the house.
This is the southern kingdom. This would be, at the time, this would be the Pharisees and the Sadducees. Read.
And he heard music and dancing.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 26. And he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. Verse 27.
So he walking up on the house. He like, man, it's like it's going down in the house. What's, he's like, hey, come here, Trump. But like, what's all that noise?
Read. God on my con, verse 27. And he said to him, thy brother is come, and thy father has killed the fatted calf because he has received him safe and sound.
He's like, nigga, it's going down. Your brother back home, nigga, they turning up in the house. He's like, what? He's like, man, that boy, they done killed Bessie. Bessie, the fat one? Bessie gone. They
right.
Done eating Bessie's steak. All that. They like, what? So now this boy hating. He hot. Keep reading.
Verse 28. And he was angry.
He hot. He looking at, man, how this nigga been going all this time? And they killed the best thing we got for this old wicked nigga.
Right.
Read.
And would not go in.
Hmm.
Therefore came his father out and entreated him.
Like, boy, what you doing? Why you ain't going in the house? Why you ain't coming in and get on this? We got steak, lamb. You know what I'm saying? We got the best. We got, you better come here and get you a plate. Like, man, I ain't going in there with that nigga, man. He reading.
Damn right. Got out of Wakan, verse 29. And he answering, said to his father, lo, these many years do I serve thee, neither transgress I at any time thy commandment, and yet you never gave me a kid, that I might be married with my friends.
You can't tell me this ain't Judah. Come on now. You can't tell me this ain't the Southern Kingdom. He like, man, I've been down with you from the jump. I've been keeping the laws. You ain't never threw no party like this for me.
Right.
I've been doing what I was supposed to do, and you ain't never did this for me. He mad. He hot. He butthurt. Look how the father handled it. Read.
Count out of one time, verse 30. But as soon as this, thy son was come, which hath devoured the living with harlots, thou hast killed for him the fatted calf.
Keep reading.
Verse 31. And he said it to him, son, thou art ever with me, and all that I have is thine.
Keep reading.
Verse 32. It was meet that we make merry, mm-hmm. we should make merry, mm-hmm. and be glad, for this thy brother was dead and is alive again and was lost and is found.
Now, he's saying, look, man, this is a blessing, man. This brother, he was dead to me, living in sin, but now he lives. He was lost, and now he's found. Man, this ain't no time for you to be mad. This ain't no time for you to be upset. And that's what the Jews, that's what the Pharisees and the Sadducees, that's what they was looking at the disciples like, why y'all teaching these niggas? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It was like, when the disciples seen Cornelius walk in, it was like, what are you doing teaching him? He from over there.
Right.
Don't mess with them no more. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man. This Bible is talking about our people. You understand? And this is the jealousy of a brother that's mad that his other brother came back home. That's what's happening all through this Bible. Now, let's get the cuts. Let me get Acts. Ooh, which one I want first? Give me Acts 11 and 19. Acts 11 and 19. Read that.
The book of Acts, chapter 11, verse 19. Now they which were scattered abroad, mm-hmm. upon the persecution that arose about Stephen, mm-hmm. traveled as far as Phoenicia, mm-hmm. and Cyprus of Antioch, mm-hmm. preaching the word to none but unto the Jews only.
Wait a minute, time out. Say it again.
Preaching the word to none but unto the Jews only.
That's what we do in the Israelite School of Universal and Practical Knowledge.
Right.
We out there teaching to our people only. We out there, what's your nationality? What is your father?
Damn right.
Go get your father. This is for you. What's your father? Oh, white man, this is not for you. Because we teach to the Jews only. We teach to the nation of Israel only, like the disciples did. This is after the day of Pentecost. That's the reason I pulled this scripture. It's because this, the day of Pentecost was in, what, like chapter 10 or 9. After that, when the disciples went out with the Spirit, they were still only teaching to the Jews only.
Right.
Period. Give me Acts 21 and 20. Acts 21, verse 20.
Book of Acts, chapter 21, verse 20. And when they heard it, they glorified the Lord and said unto him, thou seest, brother, how many thousands of Jews are there which believe?
Wait a minute. How many thousands of everybody
there? How many thousands of Jews there are which believe?
Now he coming in, who is this, Paul? He coming in to give his report to the elders. Like, he coming in to tell them, like, this is what I've been doing. And they like, all right, so how many thousands of Jews believe what you said? Keep reading.
God of one kind. And they are all zealous of the law. Verse 21. And they are informed of thee, that thou teachest all the Jews which are among the Gentiles.
He teaches who?
All the Jews, which are among the Gentiles.
He's going out and handpicking who he teach. All the Jews among the Gentiles. Read.
To forsake Moses, saying that they ought not to circumcise their children, neither walk after their customs.
Keep reading.
Verse 22. What is it therefore? The multitude must need to come together, for they will hear they art thou come. Slide you. For they will hear that thou art come.
That's what he's saying. He's saying, look, I went out to the Jews amongst the Gentiles to teach them to forsake the punishment of the law. You know what I'm saying? Like, if this man ain't circumcised, he ain't got to get circumcised. Because it ain't about that no more. It's about us coming together.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If it's about following the laws, statutes, and commandments the Lord gave us and loving each other. Stop hating each other and destroying each other and kicking each other out and not affiliating with each other and loving only each other.
Right.
That's what this is about. He says, so I'm telling them, don't even worry about, just worry about loving one another. That's why it says these two is the greatest commandment. That don't mean that the law is done away with. That don't mean you can do what you want to do. That just means now you got to live it and now you got to do it. It means you're more responsible for keeping the law than you was under, because the difference was you was living and following the laws because you was afraid of the punishment.
Right.
Now you're living and following the law because you want to. There's no punishment. You are living and following the laws because you want to. It's in your heart that you love the Most High in Christ. So you're doing it out of your own heart, the desire of your heart. The Lord want a willing heart. You know what I'm saying? That's what it's about now. Let me get, I'm finna get ready to wrap it up. Let me get 1 Corinthians 12:1. Read that.
Come on, one, come. The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 12, verse 1. Now concerning spiritual gifts, mm-hmm. brethren, I would not have you ignorant. Mm-hmm. Verse 2, ye know that ye were Gentiles.
Wait, ye know that what?
Ye know that ye were Gentiles.
It said brethren. Now he's talking to the northern kingdom, and he's brethren, knowing that you were Gentiles. Read.
Carried away into these dumb idols.
Carried away doing all this wickedness. Read.
Even as ye were led. Verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore I give you an understanding that no man speaking by the Spirit of God calleth Jesus a curse.
Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
And that no man can say Jesus is the Lord but by the Holy Ghost.
Ain't nobody out here saying that the Lord, that Christ is cursed, it has the Spirit on them. That's not, you can't say that. Them niggas is wicked.
Right.
It says, so I'm trying to tell you what to watch out for, because y'all don't know how we get down now. You know what I'm saying? Anybody that's out here saying that Jesus is a curse is not with us. He's not with the Lord. You understand? You got to understand that they were carried away. They were called Gentiles, but they are not Gentiles anymore. You understand? That's what the point of that was. Let me get Ephesians 2:11. Ephesians 2:11. Read that.
It's the book of Ephesians, chapter 2, verse 11. Wherefore remember that ye being in the time past Gentiles.
In the time past, read.
Gentiles in the flesh,
mm-hmm.
who were called uncircumcision.
You were called uncircumcision. Keep reading.
By that which is called the circumcision.
So you were saying you're not a part of the fold by the people who were claiming to be a part of the fold. Read.
In the flesh made by hands.
In the flesh. But this is spiritual. The spirit made the northern kingdom be able to come back. Because if Christ wouldn't have died, if he wouldn't have been the perfect sacrifice, we would still have to sacrifice. And they would still be cast out.
Right.
It had to be done that way. Keep reading.
Verse 12. That at the time ye were without Christ,
mm-hmm.
being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel,
mm-hmm.
and strangers from the covenants of the promise,
mm-hmm.
having no hope and without God in the world. world.
You was cast away having no hope without the Most High because you didn't have a perfect sacrifice. You didn't have Christ. So while that was happening, you was bound drawn. But now you got the Most High. It's just you got a way back to the Father. You know what I'm saying? That's what we try to get you to understand. You understand? Now, let's get it out of Christ's mouth. Let's get Matthew 15 and 24. Then you know that the disciples did the same thing Christ did. I mean, the disciples did. Christ taught the same thing, and the disciples acted it out. Read that.
The book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Christ said it out his own mouth. I'm not sent for you. I don't care about these other people. I'm only sent for the lost sheep of the house of Israel. That's it. It ain't got nothing to do with you, white man. It's family business.
Right.
It ain't got nothing to do with you, Arab and Chinese. This is Ethiopians. This is family business.
Damn right.
I am only sent for the lost sheep. Who were lost? People that's out here calling themselves Mexicans and Puerto Ricans and Dominicans. You don't know who you are. You ain't calling yourself by your tribe. You ain't calling yourself. Africans calling themselves by their tribe. I am Nigerian from the Nigeria tribe. You know where you from. I'm right. Somalian. You understand? Well, nigga, I'm Judah. I'm a Judite.
Damn right.
From the tribe of Judah.
Right.
The same tribe Christ came from. You know what I'm saying? We were lost, though, but now we are found. We were blind, but now we see. You understand? Give me Matthew 10 and 5. Let's see what Christ says.
It's the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 5. These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying.
Wait, did he give them an option?
These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them.
He commanded them, saying what?
Go not into the ways of the Gentiles.
Wait a minute. So you mean to tell me that Christ changed his mind after he died and came back? Like, you know what? Go ahead and go to the Gentiles. No. He was telling them, don't go to these other nations. But what? Keep reading.
Slovakia. And into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not.
Don't go into any city of the Samaritans, meaning these Ethiopians, these other nations. Don't go out to them teaching, trying to teach them the salvation. But, keep reading.
Verse 6, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Go to your own people. Don't go out teaching this to nobody else. Go rather unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. No one else.
Right.
Because Christ died for his people. Give me 1 Peter 1 and 1. We're about to get out of here. Get these last two. We trying to get you to understand that Christ only died for his people, man. The Gentiles that can be saved were only the people that were scattered abroad. That's it. This ain't for nobody else. Read that.
This is the book of 1 Peter, chapter 1, verse 2.
Mm-hmm.
Elect according to the foreknowledge of God the Father,
mm-hmm,
through sanctification of the Spirit.
No, 1 Peter 1 and 1.
Salakia, 1 Peter 1 and 1. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ,
mm-hmm,
to the strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatians, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia.
The strangers scattered throughout. Who are the strangers that are scattered abroad? Who are those people? Israelites. Matter of fact, let me get a stranger scripture for those who don't believe. Let me get Leviticus 19 and 17. Just for those people who don't know who the strangers are. Because they're going to say, the strangers is everybody, see? That's it. That's it.
It's the book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 17.
Mm-hmm.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
Don't hate your brother in your heart. Read.
thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
Don't rebuke your neighbor. These same people, your brother and your neighbor, are the same people, because you ain't stay among everybody back in the Bible.
Damn right.
Everybody, Edomites stayed in their own land. The Amorites stayed in their own land. Now, your neighbor were your brothers. Keep reading.
God of the one kind. And not suffer sin upon him.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 18. They shall not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
The children of thy people.
But thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Yep. I am the Lord.
Right. That stranger. Matter of fact, let me get a better one. Give me Leviticus 25 and 35. I think that should be a better one. Yeah, that's cool. That should get the point.
Yeah, Go ahead. Real good. It's the book of Leviticus, chapter 25, verse 35. And if thy brother be waxen poor.
If anybody else wax poor.
If thy brother shall be waxen poor,
mm-hmm,
and falling in decay with thee,
mm-hmm,
then thou shalt relieve him.
Mm-hmm.
Yea, though he be as a stranger.
Right.
So like, though as he be a stranger.
Mm-hmm.
Or a sojourner,
mm-hmm,
that he may live with thee.
That stranger that's scattered abroad were your brothers.
Damn right.
This scripture right here is saying, if your brother get broke, get poor, and he owe you some money, bring him in your house, man. Give him a job. Let him pay that debt off by working for you, and then let him go.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? This is a law of brotherhood. We should never be poor. None of our people should be on the streets. We should have businesses to where we can help our people help themselves. But being that we're trying to love every damn body else, you don't have nothing for your damn self. Give me James 1 and 1.
God of one kind.
I just want y'all to understand that the white man is the devil, the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
He's been lying to you all this time, telling you that salvation was for everybody. And it's a damn lie. It's not in the Bible. If you think it's, if you got a scripture that you try to prove that we're lying, post it. And we'll deal with it. We'll deal with your scripture. Go ahead, read it.
It's the book of James, chapter 1, verse 1. James, a servant of God and the Lord Jesus Christ, mm-hmm, to the 12 tribes of which are scattered abroad, greeting.
James, a servant of Jesus Christ to the 12 tribes. This is way in James. Christ dead. The disciples are out teaching. But he's still saying to the 12 tribes that are scattered abroad greeting.
Right.
This ain't for nobody else, man. I mean, it's just what it is. There's only 12 gates to the kingdom of heaven, not 18. It's only for the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. If you are not black, Hispanic, or Native American, you are not eligible for salvation.
Right.
Period. I don't care what your pastor say. I don't care what the internet say. I'm telling you what does say the Lord according to the Bible. I'm Officer Yachazak with the Israelite School of Universal and Practical Knowledge. We are not affiliated with no other Hebrew Israelite camp. If you are not in the ISUPK, you are not in the truth.
Damn right.
Shalom.
I've been in the body over this a call, listening to Carlos and Tanner pick the guitar strings. I've been fucking with my cholos since a couple years before 2000. I remember used to have that 2000. When I hit the block, them niggas, they was like, oh no, here come the loco. Throw blows with no blows, just a motherfucking chokehold. One West, we never rattle. Other niggas scared, so them niggas go and tattle. All you niggas weird, you niggas don't battle. All my niggas box, my niggas don't shadow. So if it come to blows and a niggas feeling slow bad, I take my time with the nigga, get that nigga the slow jab. Before you think you can stand in this line of niggas, I'ma have to reline a nigga. Be prop, start working on your timing. Stand up straight, take a little bit of pride in them boots too, though. Here go a little bit of shining. Hold this post, go to speaker with your life, fam. Never drop your sword, hold it for a lifespan. That's why forever I'm the right man.
Them other niggas just a hype man. Good night. That's General Mahyman.